So the next thing is about the phenotype and genotype. So in the past, when people study biology, they want to understand the biology. You know the DNA is the fundamental things for the life, right? So of course you can study DNA straight away nowadays. But in the past, you don't know about DNA. You don't even know what is the protein. Long time ago, right? You just know that every organism is somehow different. Different species is different. Okay? And you study the life, the biology, based on the morphology, phenotypes. Then after that, we know that actually this phenotype, these are the protein. So you study the protein. In addition to the phenotype, the morphology, you also study the protein. Okay? Different composition of protein. And now, we know that the protein actually is coded in the gene, DNA, in the gene. So now we study the gene. In the past, before PCR, okay, it's very hard to study genetic. You really need a lot of the material to extract a DNA, and then only then you can study them. And you don't even know what is an ATCG. Okay. There are a few tools that they use to study genetic variation. So there are two key features of the double helix structure of the DNA. You know the DNA is making of the ATCG, okay, it's arranged. And there's a genetic code, what we call the codon. So there are two strands, there are mirror image of each one and the other. Okay. Because there are two strands, that's the reason why they can replicate. Okay. And each of the strands become a template, and then they just make another exact copy. Okay? And in this way, then you can pass this information to the next generation. So actually, there should be no error. Okay. But somehow, for example, in human genome, there are more than 3 billion base pairs. There must be some error. Okay? Whenever the error is happened, if it's happened in your gene, and the gene has a particular function, then that means that you will be in trouble. Okay? Because those genes, they code for certain protein, then they will have a disease, what we call the genetic disease. Okay? If the copy error happens in those regions is not really functional, then it's okay. Okay? So that's the reason why when there's an error in the copying, there's a mechanism in your body, in your cells, that will correct it. Okay? Correct it. Okay? The reason that you have the cancer because the mechanism is failed to correct the copy error. So that means that from one generation passed to the other generation, let's say from mother, parent to the kids, okay, to the children, most of the gene, okay, those sequence that responsible for a certain function for to produce certain protein, usually will not change. Okay? Will not change. They might change, there might be some changes, but usually it's in the third codon. For the same amino acid, they can have different type of the codon, right? Usually only the third one is changed is different. Okay? So if happened there, it's still okay. Okay. And for those error that is happened not in the gene, that is more likely to pass to the next generation. Okay? There are, for example, if I pass to here, there's one nucleotide in this region, let's say 200 base pair. Now pass to the next generation, one nucleotide is changed to from G to A. Okay? So now this for offspring and parent, for the 200 base pair, this part, all the sequence is the same except one nucleotide. Then after that, this one passed to the next generation. The error happened in the same region, but different nucleotide, different position. Now there's another position in this nucleotide in the sequence, change from A to T. Okay? So now you see just two generations. The second generation, there are two nucleotides different from the parent. Okay? So this is how the genetic variation happens. Okay? So, and you know that genetic variation is very important. If everything is the same, then they will not have a genetic variability. Okay? That means that all the morphology, everything is the same. You know that for the natural selection to happen, for the species to survive, there must be the genetic diversity, right? So this is about the importance of the DNA.